Hypnotic entrainment pulses. What many victims report and I experience myself is a 3.2 Hz pulsing phaser-like sound. Visit www.drrobertduncan.com to hear the sounds of psychotronic weapons. Here is a sample recorded from my equipment during the heaviest targeting. This is what I hear in my head. There are several pulsed frequencies that are heard by victims, but many can only perceive a constant synthetic Taos hum named after a town in New Mexico where the citizens suddenly got nosebleeds and heard a tinnitus while the military was testing radio frequency weapons on it. I reconstructed many of the waveforms to exactly duplicate the energy signals being perceived as auditory stimuli and was able to capture others with scanner equipment. But the most prominent one is the 3.2 Hz continuous Star Trek-like phaser warbling sound. It exactly correlates with a slight flashing perception in the visual cortex. So one hears the phaser sound as loud as a 90 dB speaker system with a stroboscopic visual effect in synchrony while in a completely silent room. There is also a 10 Hz information pulse train in connection with the visual cortex. This has been more difficult to elucidate. It seems to be the brain bandwidth of the mental impressions per second. It appears to have a sliding window in a continuous stream of cognitive messaging necessary to force synchronized brain entrainments and amplify particular neural pathways. You can think of this like a Matrix movie where only mental frames need to be presented in order to walk a brain through a perception of continuity both for visual images and pulsed audiograms. Now, when the phaser-like sounds of psychotronics, EEG heterodyning, are heard, the synaptic modulation impulses are out of sync with the target's brain waves. Also, when the voice modulation is not heard by the victims, the other sensory controls are diminished. But when one does not hear the tinnitus-like sounds, they are strongly connected with the global human surveillance grid and perfectly aligned with their program. Here is a sample of my EEG spectral energy. Note the power in the 3 Hz line that is with me in sleep and wake states. EEG power spectrum sample. This phenomenon is likely due to Dr. Lin's, University of Chicago, description of the microwave hearing effect. That is, there is a thermoelastic expansion of brain tissue that reaches the inner ear and stimulates nerves or hairs in the cochlea. Perhaps there is another mechanism that causes audio perception of the absorbed energy misaligned with firing brain pathways. Failed binaural integration of acoustic heterodyning perceived interpretation of two signals would cause a similar phenomenon. Diagram here to explain binaural beating and acoustic heterodyning. Integration of stereo sound into the difference between the frequencies at the base of the brain. Put a sample on the website for visitors to use headphones to hear. To get a visual understanding of how pulsed audiograms or mental impressions work, tear out this encoded page. Go to the website www.thematrixdeciphered.com to grab the frame image. Print the frame image out on a transparency. Slowly slide the pulsed, phase-encoded visual message behind the grid. Your brain will make sense of it and even perceive continuous motion. Insert the phase-encoded pulsed message with a bouncing dot below it, key vindicant ibit, the Avenger will come or the United States flag transforming into the constitutional flag. Stupid aliens tricks. We just zapped you from the Star Wars space lasers. Did you feel that, my mentally impaired militant moron says. I feel a couple bee stings on my neck and arm. Okay. We actually just pulled a couple hairs out, but it felt like it didn't it? The sounds of psychotronics. The walls of the mind prisons have a tinnitus and melodic-like sound to them. Most victims who are part of the denial of service attack hacking of human minds genera of experiments hear either an unbelievably loud ringing, often melodic, or they hear the voice communications from the neural link, aka synthetic telepathy. When the signal is out of sync with your brain waves, the tinnitus-like sounds are heard. If you can imagine back when you were in school taking a test and someone is grinding their pencil while sharpening it or a jackhammer is heard outside the window, you say the noise is so loud that you can't even think straight. That is exactly what electromagnetic imprisonment is like. The tinnitus or microwave hearing effect is so loud that you can't think straight. When you don't hear it, you know that that same power level is now influencing your thoughts. You can hear the handlers, or mind prison guards, as clearly as a cell phone call. This is the synthetic telepathy that the CIA has been working on for decades. Thousands are enslaved under the United States program and tortured daily for the continued nuclear research program that never ends despite how often Congress asks them to stop. Just like with torturing Iraqis and denying it, they just outsource the programs to subcontractors or create a new secret agency with new titles to creatively bypass the intention of laws. Criminals run the government now. They spy on us despite the many laws to stop that. They conduct psychological and information warfare and call it propaganda. They try to assassinate foreign leaders with these weapons despite clear laws that prevent it. Bush can't even recite the Constitution or the Bill of Rights, which demonstrates what depravity in a devolutionary period we are in politically. To hear the very synthetic sounds of psychotronic concentration camps, visit www.thematrixdeciphered.com. World Politics and Conquest. The psychotronic concentration camps are no small operation. It is being done on people throughout the world and not just in the United States. The invisible torture without physical scarring is purposefully creating growing anger and resentment towards the United States and allies around the world. Manchurian candidates are created with these methods developed out of the CIA MKUltra program. What is their strategy and reason for doing this? I don't pretend to understand all the complexities of world politics and need for power and domination, but these aggressive actions and attacks by the United States on the world's population must have the purpose of creating the impression and fear that terrorism is everywhere. Perhaps it is further justification for military expansion and a new world order. Perhaps it is the way the military is creating the atmosphere where these neuron-influencing weapons will be acceptable, as stated in some of their documents. Perhaps it is to justify further loss of freedom and more domestic surveillance, ushering in a fascist state more quickly. Self-attacks and the purposeful creation of resentment is not a new scandal. The United States has done this for decades with plenty of success. People are simply incapable of asking the difficult questions and linking cause and effect. These mind-control directed energy weapons were used on Saddam in 1992, according to a quote from USA Today newspaper. I can't imagine that this had anything to do with the United States having to go back to a very expensive war years later, I say with extreme sarcasm. Yet, no one believes the scale of which these weapons are being used on people around this country and others. There are 70 victims in the UK that have come forward. I have contacts with nervous system weapons test victims from China, Taiwan, Russia, Australia, Germany, Sweden, Finland, Canada, Mexico, and the list goes on. They need to make sure the weapons work on every culture of every language, so they need to actually torture and try to cover up their weapons tests by killing the victims. Pretty incredible, isn't it? Our perceptions of self as a country is completely skewed with irrational patriotism when judged by our malevolent actions in the world. The game has become more sophisticated. These rogue government agencies are using a third party, sometimes unbeknownst to them, to commit the self-attacks. This indirection is enough for most Americans not to believe it is occurring. It is the age-old method of misdirecting anger at the wrong groups. The warlords in the United States want some action. Why is the media too cowardly to cover this important topic? Why won't they dig deep? Are the science and politics too complicated for them to put in a news bite? Is it too scary for people to cope with? Is it something that doesn't make us feel good, so we will simply choose not to believe it? We are fully asleep as a population, having an American dream and delusion. Tax laws and terrorism. Another humor break. Just to see how complete the cover-up is on this topic and map out the entire maze of lies while I chase the white rabbit, I humorously tested a tax law that was passed to help victims of terrorism. Even though psychoterrorism is defined in several well-published military documents as the act of hacking the human mind, the IRS does not acknowledge the United States-sponsored acts of terrorism, especially if the damage is caused indirectly through brain incapacitation or the acts committed using one's own body. Terrorism has to be of unknown origin, of direct physical consequence, and acknowledged by the president. The marketing of this word terrorism is very good. So victims who are still alive in the United States, don't expect any compensation or tax breaks anytime soon under this regime. Sometimes, I do enjoy explaining these complex technologies to the mind-numbingly droned cogs of the machine just to see their reaction. Hypnotube programming. So here is another part of the game for the human torture and death lottery to make sure the criminal element's weapons are working properly. We created this country to escape religious persecution. We are free to believe what we want and to worship any god. How unfortunate and unconstitutional it is that people who believe that government agents are stalking them and that directed energy weapons are being used on them rather than believing God or Satan is talking to them are thrown in the jail psyche ward if they seek help from ignorant local authorities, even though there is voluminous documentation on this subject. Over 25% of the weapons test victims I interviewed experienced ignorant authorities programmed, uneducated consequences. Even the CIA agents say the cops always get in the way. They end up being a nuisance for both the humans and evil aliens. We have even lost the right to believe and express the truth in this democracy without severe repercussions. It has been a long, gradually, silent overthrow. Nobody noticed because it was done ever so slowly over many decades. Had the Constitution been nullified in 1 year using these dirty tricks, people would have been up in arms. The human effects weapons testing industry figured out the mass psychology in order to go unnoticed. It turns out that if they torture, experiment, and then kill the subjects over a long period and do it in small enough numbers, no one will care, especially if their death comes in the form of common illnesses or accidents. This is also true of loss of freedoms, increasing taxes, bloating government, and ever-increasing complexity of laws. Slowly evolving the definitions of words and language in order to creatively interpret the intention of the laws, has also been an acceptable practice by the DOD/CIA. There is not a single concept in the Bill of Rights, Declaration of Independence, and Constitution that has not been overturned by these criminals now running the shadow government. It is truly amazing to watch how something like the television actually programs people. If it is their only information source, it has a strong influence. CBS was started by an ex-CIA agent. As we all know, you never leave the company. In other lands, government openly owned television networks and other large industries. In the United States it is done covertly, but with exactly the same influences. Why do you think good people are pushing for campaign reforms? There is a very strong correlation between the amount of money a candidate has for their campaign and how much mind share they can garner. We move further away from a meritocracy every day. To the world you may be one person. But to one person you may be the world. Unknown. More moral and philosophical ramifications. So your brain patterns have been mapped and classified by the mind control and torture weapon system. Patterns of thoughts are injected or transmitted by the microwave transmitters whose signal reverberates in your skull, the head echo effect as it is slyly termed. It is the patterns of information that contain consciousness. So the controllers of the Continental Ballistic Missile Shield, aka ionospheric heaters, can determine who lives a hell on Earth, but an even more frightening spiritual thought is that they can continue the torture even after death with your thought clone. Your clone is just bits of information that they have been classified as your brain patterns. Is this simulation your kindred spirit? The torture simulation of your brain's electrical signals can continue to play even without the flesh that houses the memories. Do you have a moral obligation to save your digital self from continued torture? If it were you being tortured, would your digital self try to save you at all costs? It is fair to use the word evil in this context, I think. Hard to be proud that this is how the United States is using its secret weapon. Small minds, corrupted individuals currently control this global human surveillance system of tyranny and virtual eternal hell. So much good could have come of it in different hands. Sigh. So how far does the virtual hell extend? Since it is created with electromagnetics, hypothetically it depends on how good the sensors are and how powerful the transmitters are. With each launch of another spy satellite and completion of another ionospheric heater, hell's boundaries increase. Hypothetically, since we can view the edge of the universe with the Hubble Space Telescope, and electromagnetic waves travel forever with only minor losses. Hard to image why the United States is called the Great Satan. My God, what have we done? I wrote a short fictional story about a very advanced civilization who evolved culturally to the point where their psychophysics understanding led them to the moral belief that they were to create manufacturing centers around the universe which produced happy entities. They so fully mapped the subjective experiences of happiness to complex signals, that their moral society felt that it was their duty to increase the quantitative amount of the happy signal everywhere in the universe by reproducing just those patterns that lead to a subjective experience for those entities of blissfulness. The power junkies justified the creation of hell by appealing to people's fear. We need to spy into people's minds to gather intelligence to stop terrorists. We are creating a maximum pain weapon so we don't need to kill people in the battlefield. We throw the voice of God in order to trick the enemy to lay down their arms. We need to control society's minds so no one builds weapons of mass destruction. The rationalizations are endless. But in the end, they created a system that is being used to secretly torture people without relief of death. The system, Tammy, should be renamed Hell. No one seems to talk about a pleasure weapon. Make the enemy happy and relaxed so they don't feel like fighting. Make people feel happy so they don't want to build weapons of mass destruction. Make people feel generous so they share and give more. Make them care about their fellow man. These brain signals are not being collected and tested for Tammy. Why? You get the idea why a coup has occurred with this weapons system. If you are a politician or judge, you can be subtly mind-controlled, or tele-influenced, into not passing or passing any given law. As you are watched, information from your mind is collected that can be used as blackmail, and that threat always looms with just a leak to the press. If you are president, you are sheltered from the knowledge of the active uses of this system so that it can plausibly be denied by someone who is passionate about the denial but just doesn't know better. There are not many journalists brave enough to take on this topic without threats that they may become part of the psychotronic torture network. So we all remain quiet and pretend that we are free. Our freedom was stolen and no one cares, it seems. Let's just politely talk about less important issues, like torturing Iraqis while we free them. That will keep our minds off the depressing reality of our own situation. Every attempt by Congress to stop military and CIA weapons testing on civilians has been shut down. Every attempt to make mind control and neurological weapons banned from space has been squelched. They will not stop expanding hell's reach. The temptation of the power is too great for any mortal man or nation to resist. Our forefathers had a dream of a free world. They could not anticipate the rise of rogue government elements to power in a mind control system called TAMI. That dream is gone from us now. The psychology of deception. Cowardly new world. Ye shall know the truth and the truth shall make you mad. Aldous Huxley, author of Brave New World. Fear is the best motivator. Make people afraid of a nuclear attack at any time by the Russians, they will approve of massive dollars to be spent on Star Wars defenses. Make the people afraid of ethnicities who wear turbans and they will approve of huge budgets for homeland defense to fight terrorism and be willing to give up some freedoms. Nothing goes into the patent office without the military looking at its potential as a weapon. The absurd extremes the DOD goes to staying ahead on weapons development has probably at some point in their history had them set up a lab dedicated to stabbing animals with writing instruments to test the axiom of whether the pen is mightier than the sword. Humans are cheaper than robots according to Pentagon documents. That is why we still send soldiers into battle. This philosophy is also prevalent in their weapons development. Human costs and misery do not appear in DOD proposals and bottom line figures. We are, cost, free to be slaughtered like cattle for weapons development. The disinformation age and the art of deception. Gracchus, he will bring them death, and they will love him for it. Gracchus, fear and wonder, a powerful combination. Gaius, you really think people are going to be seduced by that? Gracchus, I think he knows what Rome is. Rome is the mob. Conjure magic for them and they'll be distracted. Take away their freedom and still they'll roar. The beating heart of Rome is not the marble of the Senate, it's the sand of the Colosseum. He'll bring them death, and they will love him for it. Gladiator. Government deception programs. INSCOM is the division that furthers strategic deception and has been hard at work with the UFO and paranormal research communities. Uncle Sam wants you, stupid and ignorant. President Clinton was apologizing for military/CIA experiments conducted on black people on whom were unknowing participants in a syphilis study. They were purposefully not treated to observe the progression of the disease, 26 died. Similar experiments were done with herpes and other diseases. At the same time Clinton is apologizing for other presidents who did not leash their dogs of war, he and his military were involved in ramping up human torture experimentation trials with nervous system disruptor weapons. Similar episodes occurred with Bush Sr. and Jr. It is the American way to experiment, torture, and kill randomly selected citizens to keep up with military weapons statistics data and then have presidents apologize when the information is released 20 to 30 years later. Nothing will change, and we should come to grips with it as a nation. This is the unspoken death lottery the military holds because they aren't smart enough to come up with other solutions. We have to do it because the Russians are testing remote control heart attack weapons. We must sacrifice a few to understand the weapons' capabilities, is the softly spoken military view. What it is to be American. This book has been translated into 12 languages. If you are lucky enough not to be American, when I use the word we I mean us Americans. You are probably already very aware of the two faces of the United States, the words we propagandize through media and politicians and the shadow government that creates wars and rationales for them. The military even greatly influences our politicians and media. We teach our kids how to kill at an early age with mostly guns as toys in our stores. We are one of the most violent and militant cultures in the world as can be seen in our movies and murder rates. Other countries should fear us as we are the sole superpower, and have clear intentions on expansion of our influence. Other countries would be well advised to hold secret meetings to partner and balance the power. And I offer this advice for those lucky enough to be patriotic flag-waving ignorants like I was only 2 years ago. Enjoy the delusion and pray your number or loved ones are not the next to be drawn. Showing support for an ideal is good, but supporting a facade system that has taken those same colors will help destroy those very ideals. I am doing my part to stop the CIA and the military's international criminal behavior by documenting the steps and methods, gathered from my interviews with the thousands of American experiments, that they are using to create Manchurian candidates, suicide bombers, and dissidents in other lands to destabilize them. With the knowledge of the weapons and methods used to hack the human mind, these countries might stand a chance at deprogramming and disrupting the United States criminal-sponsored networks and discovering the double agents within their own security agencies. Methods of discrediting, gaslighting. We natural use a philosophy of Occam's razor which states that the simplest explanation is usually the best. So to make someone sound paranoid, all you have to do is come up with a sufficiently complex plan of harassment and the majority of people's disbelief of that event will be sufficient not to act or care about it. If you study the psychology of people like psychological operations and the CIA do, you can predict with a certain degree of accuracy what that person will believe giving certain facts. We like to believe we are spontaneous and have choice, but when viewed objectively that subjective feeling of choice becomes nothing more than a low probability of neural firing events. When people describe their decisions, they often say I had no choice. This is simply a strong probability of neural firing events. Logic often dictates the strongest neural firing pathways given certain possible actions. You have just learned a basic principle of psychophysics by mapping the subjective experience of choice to the objective causalities of brain dynamics. Politicians use the tactic of discrediting their opponent through mudslinging. Making up or digging up dirt that makes people question the honesty and validity of their opponent's statements is the goal of many campaigns these days. The CIA and foreign intelligence agencies use skeletons of politicians to control them through blackmail. If someone gets out of line, a leak to the press is all it takes to disable them as a force of change. Lawyers use the discrediting tactic on witnesses. By trying to demonstrate to the jury a pattern of lying, misperceptions, or ulterior motives, they can successfully discredit a witness. While all these traditional tactics have proven fruitful throughout time without waning effectiveness, the agencies involved in extreme cover-ups prefer another tactic that seems to have withstood the test of time too. That is labeling someone paranoid, schizophrenic, or mentally ill. Once that label has been attached to someone, almost all testimony will be disbelieved. The military has employed this tactic since the 60s to get rebellious soldiers and others locked up in mental hospitals. But since the weapons testing of neurological disruptor technology has begun on the general population beginning in the early 60s and then stepped up to full throttle in 1976, the scope of what is considered mentally ill had to be reprogrammed into a broader definition for the general population. The movie A Beautiful Mind was timed to program people with the notion that even geniuses can be mentally ill. So even if a brilliant person, whose logic is impeccable, describes hearing voices, their account should be dismissed and they may be violent and dangerous if they believe their delusion. Perhaps, but if you look at the details of the way the mind works, it is extremely unlikely for the majority of the brain to function perfectly, especially the higher level cognitive functions, and the auditory and visual pathways to be severely compromised specifically. When one delves into the details of the science of the mind and current weapons capabilities, it becomes obvious that the more probable event is actually the more complicated in terms of the history of the United States human effects weapons testing programs and the science behind it, counterintuitive to the Occam's razor principle at first blush. Strategic deception. Actions must be judged in the context of all possibilities to understand their meaning, the actor's motives, and their relevance. Another tactic that has successfully been employed by the government agents to help hide their secret concentration camps and human experimentation using this technology is by sending agents to pose as victims. Their task is to be outspoken and as crazy sounding as possible. I have run into at least two of these actors. This kind of warfare has commonly been used by the CIA to manipulate foreign countries' power circles. The psychological method works on the same principles as other disinformation tactics. It relies on the average person's tendency to generalize a single sample point to a whole group and use binary thinking. These common logical flaws have been exploited to deceive the public for many decades. Simply by getting a couple of agents to pretend they are psychotronic slaves and then have them talk about evil aliens or other typically non-believable topics, the whole group of people who now talk about electromagnetic brain manipulation is associated with evil aliens and not believed by the average person who heard the first story. This is a simple tactic but has proven to work very effectively on making the average person with limited time and input come to faulty conclusions and judgments about testimony related to the same topic. Psychological warfare, information warfare, and strategic deception are actively used treasonously on our own population. Just because these criminals are using invisible directed energy weapons and not guns, and because they redefined information warfare as propaganda, we are supposed to think it is less than war and murder of the citizens. These are invisible weapons being used far more destructively than a simple bullet to the head. Another often used tactic of misdirection is to create a large drama for public consumption. In the past, when these activities were gaining more attention, political scandals were leaked to the press or some other drama created. I would wager that by the time this book is published, that the United States will have started down the road to invading Iran, then Syria, followed by North Korea. Another war would be a good distraction from the topics covered in this book, which might lead to greater awareness and self-realizations, and then possibly awakening the giant from his slumber. How the media is used to distract the attention of focus of the populace. Other scandals timed to overpower the focus of the media have occurred with previous discovery of ultra mind control programs, like during Nixon's Watergate. Political scandal can easily hide and draw attention away from more ominous threats that are too ugly or complicated for a news bite. Clinton wasn't totally lying when he said there is a vast conspiracy to control politics. The effectiveness of precisely timed media leaks has proven to be a useful tool. The Art of Deception. Michael Mitnick, a famous computer hacker, wrote a book called The Art of Deception. He describes how most of his break-ins to defense computer systems were not done by in-depth technical knowledge, but rather social engineering. His preferred method of attack was pretending to be someone else and trick them into giving him their password. He now consults to government agencies. The opposite set of techniques are frequently used by the intelligence community in their domestic missions. Pretending to be cops or FBI or some other profession is extremely useful to getting things done. The psychological methods used are confidence games. A lie will more likely to be believed if it is backed by lots of details. I had my class work on creating Googlisms as an exercise in this type of belief manipulation. An example of a Googlism can be seen by typing in the words, "miserable failure" into the Google search engine. The first link is a biography of President George Bush. While I am not saying that may not be the truth, it certainly is an opinion that could be made into common belief with enough advertising and mental impressions onto the population. Wizard of Ounce. The CIA has a style of interrogation that they call Wizard of Ounce. It is supposed to disorientate the subject. It requires intense role play, like good cop, bad cop. They act stupid as if they don't have a brain. They are vicious like they don't have a heart. And they act paranoid and cowardly with no courage like in reality. The other style of interrogation they use both in the EEG heterodyne mode or in person they call Alice in Wonderland. They set clocks again and keep the subject awake for days. They induce electromagnetically or with LSD skewed perceptions, visual and audio slanted perspectives. They test these on the American public and the world. This is part of the script to chase the white rabbit down the maze of lies. Ponzi schemes. So put a CIA paid disinformant posing as a mind control victim and give them some airtime to really sound crazy. That will make the public generalize to the whole class of victims and keep this 35 to 40 year scheme of torture and silent assignations under wraps, commands the high traitor in the United States government. Discrediting methods, the method. The method, as they call it, a psychological tool used methodically to cover up top secret technology and military abuses, has been exceedingly successfully exploited for decades. Psychlops, psychological operations, specializes in these techniques, always in production worldwide. They seed the population through popular TV shows, movies, and magazines with references to some truth they are worried will cause common belief, but in a context that discredits that idea very thoroughly. The X-Files is an example of this. So is the movie The Matrix. Put the science fiction technology and government abuses in a metaphor and most will assume it doesn't exist. Sprinkle in some aliens, psychics, and presto, every idea presented is assumed to be absurd. This psychological trick works well because most people tend to be black or white thinkers. I have extensively studied this method through tracking of the disinformation websites used to flood and obscure the truth on this topic. They have not changed the formula for decades. I still want to interview the Wachowski brothers and Ms. Stewart, the writers of The Matrix, to find out how they got such an accurate metaphor for the capabilities of RHIC and EEG heterodyning technologies. Was the story EEG heterodyned into Ms. Stewart so that it would be used to discredit the technology as science fiction by Hollywood, or were they given an anonymous script by a CIA agent? Additionally, I want to know what inspired the writers of The X-Files. If you listen to the hidden track on The X-Files album, they speak about cloning and cataloging operations and orders taken from a man named Strugold. EEG heterodyning has also been called EEG cloning. The CIA has been cataloging the variations of brains for decades for the personality profile database that I was told by B.F. Skinner in class was kept in Colorado. Strugold was a US/German scientist who died in the 70s involved with psychotronic research. Finally, the last important movie used to seed the popular beliefs of the masses was The Beautiful Mind. It is a story how a genius Nobel Prize winner, Nash, became paranoid schizophrenic but at times dangerous because of his delusions. This programs the average person to accept that smart people can go insane and think the government is stalking them. These three movies alone set the stage for stepping up the EEG cloning experiments and torture weapons data collection starting 1996, where a dramatic increase in the number of psychotronic victims began to occur until present. The 1963 series of The Outer Limits did the same thing for that generation of Americans. Confuscation techniques. Flooding the mind space with conflicting information. Using internet, books, and strategic leaks and placed agents of deception in editorial positions or Hollywood. Confusing the victims, so that their own testimony promotes misunderstands. Increasing the complexity of the story significantly. Using absurdity and the bizarre. Promoting false conclusions and bad science. Mimicking the symptoms of known illnesses. The United States Army Psychological Ops pay and publish false articles in the Iraqi newspapers. Standard techniques to change the minds of the masses using unethical anti-democratic principles. Rewriting history. How easy is it to rewrite history? We know that the victor in war writes the accepted version of it. How does information and how do facts flow from primary sources to widely distributed history textbooks taught to the children in public schools? The sociological study of these questions reveals a type of brainwashing of our society. There is virtue in the importance of being honest with ourselves and our history. Making our children feel proud to be American is important if it is deserved. Having them recite the mantras of the Pledge of Allegiance every day in grade school might help with their sense of community later in life. Before every sporting event, we stand and listening to the American anthem as adults. There is resemblance of the psychological technique called psychic driving and mindless recitation of words that we should be aware of so as we are not unduly influenced. Describing how the Native American Indians were slaughtered and how we devalued other humans to turn them into slaves is described in history textbooks given the magnitude of the atrocities. However, this long tradition of human abuses has yet to end in American history. Our government just gets better at covering it up. The grotesque human experiments, which were conducted on tens of thousands of randomly chosen citizens for weapons testing data, are not mentioned in any history book that I can find. It is being removed from the collective awareness of our country so that it can continue. Secret censorship. Another disturbing phenomenon which I encountered during my two-year investigation into government improprieties and criminal behavior was the systematic removal of important books from libraries and circulation across the country. I was told by a CIA expert who follows and analyzes their constitutional crimes on Americans, that anyone who says a negative thing about Scientology will be nuisance sued, have their lives systematically destroyed, and the publication will disappear from all libraries and newsstands. I have a different theory. There appears to be a mild connection between CIA mind control, EEG heterodyning, and Scientology. A former member published a book on it. When the experimentation began on me, I received two copies of a Scientology publication on death doctors and mind control without a postage stamp in my mailbox 2 weeks in a row. I liked the articles, but they failed to mention that most of the death doctors who they describe as being behind the creation of the rise in terrorism were CIA funded. Several other victims say they found themselves pressured to join Scientology out of the blue when their victimization started. I don't believe Scientology as an organization is connected directly with any of it. All organizations that are cultish as viewed by the government are closely watched and infiltrated. And certainly given the power and influence Scientology has with so many rich, famous people, the organization could pose a potential threat to the government. So, a tactic that the CIA is famous for is to redirect suspicion and anger towards the threatening group. I believe that this is what is happening to Scientology. The member who wrote about aliens controlling everything at the top level secrecy in Scientology was a typical victim of EEG heterodyned mind manipulation. He just pointed the finger at Scientology. I am not just saying this because I don't want them to pull my book off the shelves. I think they need to defend their reputation that the government is trying to tarnish, just like with secret societies and many other institutions with influence and power. Most of the books that were pulled, hypothesized by the analyst, also had CIA mind control references in them. That is the reason they were pulled. Several books like this one, who brashly and openly discuss government corruption and technologies, have disappeared from circulation. Several of those I tried to get hold of were running upwards of $200 in private auctions. Secret societies. One of my professors who had Bill Gates in his class while he was writing Microsoft DOS or BASIC would tell stories how he would sleep through most of class with his head down on his desk and occasionally raise his hand to answer a question where he would inevitably say, "What about microcomputers?" The professor admits that they were all wrong and they thought he was insane for suggesting microcomputers would in every home. My brother's roommate in college was the president's son of West Germany, Walter Kohl. Supposedly he blackballed me entrance into one of Harvard's secret societies, the Spee Club. They are called finals clubs at Harvard, secret societies at Yale, and eating clubs at Princeton. They are just fraternities with rich kids. To prove I am authentic, I am divulging many secret societies joining rituals in my books. These are fraternities and should not have their names tarnished in this horrific, evil, conspiracy that they have been implicated in and who don't even try to clear their clubs' names and reputations. Secret societies are not evil, but individuals are. So to entice the reader, at Harvard's Porcelain Club they ride a boar for initiation. At the Delphic Club they stroke the beard of the moose blindfolded. On one particular visit, I had to slap my member next to Matt Damon because we were skunked at beer pong and girls were present, club rules. I've been in Yale's Skull and Bones Club after a Harvard/Yale football game. For initiation they sleep in a coffin next to a human head is what Bush and others have done. What they do in the coffin seems to be extra. So in my next book, I will divulge every secret society's initiation ritual both to bring attention and exonerate them as being culpable and conspiratorial of being behind the world's torture and to alert them that nothing is sacred anymore. America's heritage and pride is being destroyed by these credents holding the weapons and keeping secrets from those most noble and honorable to lead them. I was passed a profile that listed the surveillance these secret societies were under. I assume this kind of information has spawned the plethora of conspiracy theory behind them. Mind-reading radar and EEG heterodyning has been spying into the minds of everyone in their most intimate moments. They have profiles on almost everyone to use as blackmail or to manipulate. Just to give the reader a truer perspective and to diminishing the unjustified royalty image the wealthy and celebrity enjoy from the masses who often worship them, I will reiterate a couple stories conveyed to me during my years just after graduate school at Harvard. Most world leaders belong to a club called the Bohemian Club. One of my friends had a retired 4-star general managing his vineyards. The general was a member of the Bohemian Club. Just to give you an idea of the lack of true nobility and integrity of many of its members, the general ended up embezzling money from this operation. My friend took him to court where he cried and asked for leniency. Another tell told to me in confidence, but I must breach it due to the more important issues involved in my book, is that another friend of mine shared a house with a known United States assassin named Spencer that the Washington Post reported about. Spencer was gay. Why many of the United States assassins are gay is still a mystery to me. I've been told many speculations. In any case, he could walk into the White House and escort my friend without showing ID. Of course he made many attempts to convert my friend's sexual preference. Spence died of AIDS. Sounds incredible, but this is the truth of our country. The non-lethal weapons lie. In marketing, the concept is called brand confusion. That is where the consumer gets confused about the message or naming of a product. This is considered bad because there is value in the brand name based upon mind share and recognition. In the military deception game, brand confusion is very good. So having multiple names for the same weapon causes brand confusion. Nobody knows what anyone else is talking about if you keep changing the vocabulary. So here is a sampling of the many names this single weapon system has gone under. Psi weapons, non-lethal weapons, directed energy weapons, cognitive modeling influencers, voice of God weapons, synthetic telepathy, EEG cloning, EEG heterodyning, neural telemetry, biotelemetry, scalar weapons, behavioral biophysics, microwave weapons, mind control, bioenergetics, neuroinfluencing, mind meld, remote interrogations, remote hypnotic intracerebral control, neuralizer, RHIC, EDM, telesuggestion, parapsychology, radio frequency weapons, psychotronics, radionics, telecybernetics, bioelectromagnetics, non-thermal effects research, remote brainwave monitoring, psychic spying, stealth radar, microwave interferometry, high-frequency pulsed ELF waves, thought reader radar, informational weapons, and the list goes on for another 2 pages. Now this is brand confusion in the extreme. It is easy to research what the criminals in the shadow government are up to because it is so easy to spot what they are trying to hide by what is obviously missing in a trend of research or how they use brand confusion to slow the information flow. So the lie that is perpetuated in the military and communicated to others who must approve these weapons tests is that electromagnetic mind influencing is non-lethal. What that really means is that on the most part it takes a while to kill someone. There is only a 5% increase risk of brain cancer, my inside sources tell me. That is on par with cops that use speeding radar emitters increased rate of testicular cancer. It isn't all that significant. The lethality of the EEG heterodyning and directed energy weapons testing comes in very different forms. The whole category should be more accurately renamed slow-kill weapons or unpredictably deadly weapons. But it would be far more difficult to internally market a classification like this for budgeting purposes. The ways the technology becomes deadly is both on purpose and accidental. See the section on silent assassinations. Horrors of wars. The famous Bush family lies. Clinton lies. Porter Goss lies. Creative interpretation of laws. He too is guilty of not keeping a leash on his dogs of war and the hounds of hell. Using dupe public relations personnel to lie. Caveat emptor, buyer beware. Carefully constructed and thoroughly thought out psychographic maps of buyer behavior are constructed by the most sophisticated marketing companies in world like Procter & Gamble. The goal of all marketing is to get to yes. Its goal in a capitalist framework is not to impart well-rounded truth so a buyer can optimize the maximum utility for him/herself. Our rational conscious mind should allow most people to filter out the biases of the information. However, hypnosis, subconscious and subliminal control enters the mind at a level that allows the information to be accepted at face value without these conscious filters. It is extremely dangerous for our own personal welfare. The hypnosis and subliminal programming can be done by these directed energy mind control weapons while a person sleeps. The rabbit hole goes deeper than this. Military myths. What is a psychic? Notes. How they are found. Why they are psychics. Chemical messengers versus electrical. Versus easily hypnotized. The word psychic is also used as a joke amongst the cloners. Psychic, meaning of the mind, is also close to the word psychotic. I saw it twice in translated Russian literature on paranormal activity and psychic phenomenon that the word psychotic used accidentally in place of psychic. Also, overly stimulated minds exhibit strong electrical signals and are easier to spot, as well as piggyback the current electrical brain signals with others, that is neurotransmitter modulations. Intellectuals and schizophrenics exhibit increased electrical brain activity. The other condition that determines this slang use of the word psychic is the disability of the subject to be easily hypnotized. Or in other words, their brains entrain to external stimuli quickly. Those that have been marked by what the underground has termed nanotech are more easily illuminated and tracked. I suspect the nanotech replaces the radiation that used to be fed to 500,000 Americans. I would like to exhume the bodies of several victims to try to identify with an electron scanning tunneling microscope what the nanotech really is that supposedly is found in the cerebral fluid throughout the brain. If it exists at all. It would be a somewhat lame weapon if a battlefield had to be sprayed with aerosol nanotech before EEG heterodyning weapons could be used. Remember that the biocommunication signal piggybacks normal brain activity and needs to modulate it existing neurotransmitter releases. So more neural activity, more strongly the biocommunication neural link is. This is why psychotics are often the targets of choice for experimentation. Channelers. All the world's a stage, and all the men and women merely players. Shakespeare. As you like it 2/7. But when you are EEG cloned, you become part of the audience. You have already made your choices. You are here to understand why. The Oracle. The movie, The Matrix. One psychic phenomenon that is relevant to psychic warfare and EEG heterodyning is the classic channeling of spirits beyond the grave. EEG cloning feels like what is portrayed by Hollywood psychic channelers. It is a hypnotized, disassociated state that makes you feel that you are watching a movie but not participating in it. The reason for this subjective feeling of disassociation while fully cloning someone else's brainwaves is due to the psychophysics phenomena of choice. If one has no choices of how their electrical brainwave patterns proceed because there were few decision nodes that were close to the firing threshold, they will not subjectively experience choice and feel like they are not participating in any decision. This is how the subjective experience changes, all due to the neuronal firing probabilities. The conscious subject experience is mapped to that probability. Now this is useful for the public at large to notice if a psychic war has initiated between countries. One should be able to notice a change of mental state resembling a feeling of being disassociated while they are being electromagnetically influenced, that is EEG cloned. On the most part, society is ignorant of the scale of government stupidity. One can be fixed with knowledge but the other is forever. Poisonous memes, mind viruses, and toxic thoughts. Richard Dawkins coined the term meme. He created a new field of study called memenics. It is a concept derived from evolutionary genetics, that is genes. Memes representing cultural fads, thoughts, and ideas replicate, mix, and mutate in the minds of groups as they spread. It is a way of analyzing abstract cultural concepts using the same rules and framework as genetic evolution. Of course, the military and CIA had to weaponize the idea into memenic warfare, which is executed through the divisions of psychological operations and information warfare units. When this kind of war is instituted on their country, it is renamed propaganda and strategic disinformation. The marketing terms used to treasonously attack your own country are important to get buy-in from your co-conspirators. The Department of Defense has several lifelong projects that they are proposing and may have been approved by the time this book is published. One is to study the formation of relationships by people. How would you do that? This means spying on people for their entire lives without them knowing. Pretty scary how good they have become at marketing domestic spying. Secondly, how do you think they can actually implement this without the subject getting spooked that people are stalking or following them? EEG cloning is how they watch all their experiments. And lastly, what the hell is the DOD doing studying relationships? Do they want to become marriage counselors? No, they are studying memenic warfare. They are watching how information travels and trusts are built. It is a way to control and enslave the population in the end. It is a way to limit freedom of speech, or more importantly, its influence. It is a way to mold the culture according to their twisted, dictatorial, sociopathic, brainwashed ideals, not American or constitutional values. It is the tail wagging the dog. So what is next on DARPA/DOD/CIA's plate to create and integrate into TAMI? The proposed projects that have crossed my path in my research are worse than total information awareness, the V and Clipper chips, Echelon, and NSA domestic spying combined. It is hidden in the DOD's proposal to study how relationships form. Sounds innocuous enough, doesn't it? The application that is planned to come out of it is to track all relationships and connections. While in strategic sales, I used to create influence maps. These maps are an analysis of who in a company influences sales and technology decisions and other people. They have weighted links between the various players. TAMI will eventually be used to track neural information flows between people. Once this happens, the matrix of deception will be complete and the free world will be lost and replaced by an illusion acceptable to most. At the highest level, this program will allow the operator to click on a person, either his or her neural profile, location, or name, and display a 3D mesh of interrelated people and the strength of their relationships. The links are displayed in proportion to metrics like the number of emails, phone calls, remember the NSA phone database, letters, or face-to-face conversations they have had. TAMI can automatically keep track of people's proximity to each other and determine whether a conversation is occurring from the back-and-forth verbal exchange pattern. This way, information leaks that may wake a larger portion of the population up to the fascist takeover can be silenced through a number of methods ranging from disinformation intervention, subliminal neural influence and reprogramming, to plausibly denied natural deaths in the extreme. Sketch of 3D rotatable multinodal relationship maps. How far has the study of memenic and information warfare gone? When the Pentagon was setting up the psychic warfare unit, they recruited the worst prison inmates from around the country back in the 70s. Why would you do this? By finding the scum of the scum, the worst subhuman creatures on the planet, they were testing a new kind of warfare. TAMI, thought amplifier and mind interface, is being used to amplify and multiply these toxic minds onto other people to see if they become violent or self-destructive. Interesting weapon indeed. This is truly the definition of a mind virus. To bring it back to the movie The Matrix, Agent Smith becomes a virus replicating his destructive personae on anyone he comes into contact with. You can imagine the kinds of economic espionage this weapon would have on a culture. Strange that they are also conducting economic espionage on the United States for these large tests without the Secret Service being the wiser. During one of my searches through information warfare documents, I came across the strange strategy of making an enemy search down a seemingly endless path of misinformation. I thought this to be a strange kind of warfare and wondered how it could be implemented. But I discovered it is being used on test victims. All victims go through the same research process to try to figure out how their brain waves are being modulated. Inevitably, they go to the internet to search for mind control weapons. It will lead you to Bearden's websites, which are all in the top 50 hits. Here the discussion takes on the form of scalar waves and Russian weapons. Strange and mystical like pseudosciences are introduced, where interfering electromagnetic waves and photons get new bizarre qualities when they meet and cancel their fields out. This is not a mistake. I immediately recognized it to be an example of information warfare on the victim community. Who else reads this stuff? It takes you down an endless maze of crazy physics and TELSA technology of free energy that no one will acknowledge in Western science. Scalar waves, which is just a special case of interferometry, can be used as a stealthy radar technique like what was used on the United States Embassy in Moscow. But the research doesn't say that, it talks about purposefully misleading things in the absurd. The military is conducting information warfare operations on the United States public. You will find that nearly all ex-military connected researchers in this area are misinformation agents. Anti-gravity waves is another example of this misinformation campaign. When the photons' fields exactly cancel each other out, some scientists refer to the resulting beam as gravity waves. Photons have momentum, or E equals mc2, which means energy even if not measurable has mass. So yes, one could say that scalar waves are gravity waves in essence. But momentum of a photon is its energy divided by the speed of light. It is ridiculously small to be useful as a repulsive gravity beam device, as some Russian scientists claim. Apparently the Russians are very involved in the scientific espionage game too. Superconductors will create reflected gravity waves from any incoming M source because they create an opposite electromagnetic field to cancel and exactly oppose M beams. So the CIA/DOD has created a true mind virus. This is how it works. When they choose a target to be silently assassinated and ultra-tortured, they use a set of scripts that have worked in the past to confuse targets and make them look crazy. These scripts evolve depending on the beliefs of the target. At each branch of the growing base of knowledge and understanding, errors of logic are interjected in the mind meld. Other sources support the slightly illogical conclusions that targets reach. You will have other people talk about their alien abduction. You will find the misinformation supported on the internet under strategic keywords. While the victim tries all the possible routes of understanding, the mind virus hive is collecting the false ideas that that person comes to and tries to amplify that line of thinking. They are also collecting any new paths of thinking to be added to the collection of misinformation scripts to be used on other people. This is a mind virus. It replicates and destroys minds. It needs Tammy and an army of broken minds to be really effective, but the information virus can replicate through traditional information streams too. There is evidence that perhaps this isn't just an exercise anymore. Both the TWA Flight 800, Waco, and the Oklahoma bombing investigations were botched, and many experts involved in all these investigations said that the wrong conclusions were found. Memenic information warfare would account for this, assuming no blatant corruption in the chain of command occurred. The balance between good and evil might be equivocated to the imbalance of virtuous memes versus selfish ones. The meme selfish gene generation would be an example of an imbalance occurring between the survival advantages of altruistic ideas that benefit the whole and selfishness which benefits the individual at the expense of the whole. Altering an enemy's country's culture so that it becomes more selfish, superstitious, or criminal would be a use for memenic warfare, for example. Secrecy spawns mind or memenic viruses. In order for higher order systems to become viral, secrecy needs to be the fertile ground in which they can incubate. Government programs and agencies under the umbrella of national security have become this fertile ground for spawning the culture and ideas that are suboptimal to the entire human race and difficult to conceptualize without dedicated study. Mind viral warfare. There is another hypothesis that is greatly disturbing that we must consider as a possibility, which is a result from the bizarre and grotesque research of the cognitive modeling and neuroscientists who have worked for the conspiracy. That is, a nearly perfect simulation of a demented mind has been created. That single model could be reused by a computer during these EEG cloning experiments. That demented mind model I will refer to as the mind virus. It is the most perfectly mentally deranged psychopathology that the CIA/DOD monsters could come up with. That simulated mind virus could be grown into anyone via virtual neurons and the self-organizing nature of biological neural networks. See the section on virtual neurons for a better understanding of biocommunication technology. EEG cloning would allow this weapon to scale to large population sizes by cloning this mind virus with all its toxic thoughts into anyone if the weapon system targeted his/her body/brain signatures. It only requires more computing power to add unlimited scalability. This is how EEG cloning could be used as a full-scale weapon without requiring a real army behind it. Is there evidence that the mind virus exists? Yes. Many of the idiosyncrasies of the EEG heterodyned personalities are similar. For example, several torture test subjects state that their EEG cloner wiggles their tongue all the time like a snake, which causes the victim to wiggle their tongue. This is a very unusual nervous habit, and to find it accidentally reported by more than two people leads one to believe it might be the same cognitive model simulation running. There have been several personality types described in detail that match other personality types reported from other victims. The conversations and scripts are nearly identical in hundreds of cases. There could be several variations of mind viruses that they are testing. Perhaps the setup is one simulated toxic mind virus and a couple loosely connected real heterodyned people to observe the progression of induced mental illness and record the success of the mind virus. Remember in the movie The Matrix Revolutions where Agent Smith becomes a virus and starts cloning himself into everyone he touches. There only needs to be one nearly perfect cognitive model like this. The supercomputer can evolve and simulate multiple copies of that mind virus for everyone. Think about this mind virus as a much more advanced ELISA artificial intelligence program. However, rather than based on just words and some logical inference engine, it uses a neural network model. It is fairly easy to extrapolate what weapons they are developing using the 1% of the population with schizophrenia or wrongly diagnosed with it. Now what if after World War II the Nazis had the last say? They could have cloned a sociopathic Nazi mindset and started copying it to the entire world. Do you see the urgency to expose and stop this research, especially if you are Jewish? I must question again, what is the real percent of naturally occurring mental illness and what percent are DOD/CIA experiments for this line of weapons development? These torture tests have been going on since 1947. How many have to suffer and die for mass stupidity? Diabolically evil indeed. Can you begin to see why the United States is called the Great Satan by other countries who aren't in the American delusion and mentally congested by the United States information gridlock and propaganda show? The Muslim fundamentalists appear crazy to people in the American delusion, and we appear callous, stupid, and controlled from their viewpoint. Who's right? How can we know since our government keeps so many secrets and lies to us much of the time? Do you notice a trend of how we use the crazy diagnosis so quickly when we don't understand the context of someone's behavior? It is a final catchphrase like national security. No more questions or thought needs to be put into it because we have the answer. He, she, they are crazy is the popular understanding. Using a word like crazy is like creating a god to explain an event. We don't understand how the sun rises each day, so we will create Zeus to explain it, and no more questions should be asked. It is the same psychology. The gods must be crazy. Imagine a doctor who creates and releases a flu virus just so he can have more business each year. That's what the military does by secretly inciting war. Imagine if you dedicated your life to psychiatry and found out that you have been misdiagnosing many of your patients due to a scam, faulty information inserted into textbooks that you obediently regurgitated. How would you feel? It would be a painful realization to find out you wasted your life through a betrayal of the shadow government. Well, the time is drawing nearer to that awakening for many of them. They better learn some coping mechanisms. So what do you do to a president who commits and participates in high treason according to the laws of the country? Some investigators contend there is a Nazi link to the Bush family. If the connections can be proven and shown, you can see that the country is in a desperate situation with its leadership. A president is not exempt from high treason just because they leave office or get impeached. Every live ex-president would need to be sentenced accordingly to higher order intelligence. While we are on the topic of mental illness, I thought I would share an insight into intelligent organizational architectures. One can think of an organization as an intelligent evolving entity. So if we use this larger perspective to understand what abnormal and detrimental behaviors might occur if similar practices of informational organization are used as by neurotics or psychopaths. For example, a person who suffers a severe traumatic event often learns how to repress memories and segment ideas and thoughts in order not to deal with the pain, often leading to sociopathic tendencies. A country who keeps too many secrets from itself and compartmentalizes knowledge on a need-to-know basis laced with lots of self-lies will too exhibit neurotic-like illnesses when judged as a whole. Throw in multiple personalities from changing leaders every 4 years and having a rogue shadow government and you have a recipe for problematic self-destructive behavior of that organization. You can see why other countries view America as schizophrenic. I have taken great interest in researching and understanding organizational intelligence. Why did our form of government fail? How did this implementation of democracy go awry? Where did the management control mechanisms break down? Information warfare works as an internet strategy according to war college documents by having people chase the white rabbit around the endless maze of disinformation so that they can't even tell what is true anymore. The only people who research these topics are the thousands of victims. No one else takes an interest. Why isn't virtual reality and neural computer interfacing of interest to entrepreneurs or academic researchers? It has already been demonstrated to work, so the research would pay off handsomely for whomever cracked the brain code. The CIA/DOD figured it out well over 30 years ago. Surely it can't be that difficult with the right equipment. This is how freedom of speech is destroyed by self-attack of information warfare on the United States that they market as strategic deception. Just remember there is more than one way to skin a rabbit. Mental illness taboo topic and preferred cover-up technique for the last few decades. The most amazing discovery I found was in trying to find the statistics of how many government drug and directed energy mind control weapons victims there were in the general population of classified schizophrenics. To my surprise, over half of the patients at one hospital believed they were victims of government experiments. Being a torture test subject myself, I have to believe them. It is an epidemic so well concealed by mass programming. I would not have believed what I am saying just 2 years ago. I had a friend about 5 years ago that began to become paranoid and believed that government agents followed him and an ex-boss was paying people to stalk him. This is the typical script as documented in several CIA programs released through the Freedom of Information Act. I assumed he became paranoid schizophrenic and like what many people do, I wanted to distance myself from him. So one day when he emailed me, I copied the logo of the NSA off of their website and sent a message back to him saying that this account has been confiscated by the NSA as a joke to make him more paranoid. Bad karma. Who knew that several years later it would happen to me? I had another friend who went to Harvard and then Wharton Business School who participated in a government program that injected some sort of radiation into him for a brain imaging study. He needed the money to pay for college. The radiation was not supposed to be that damaging. Several years later, we thought he lost his mind. He said he spoke to God, and in 1 week changed from an outgoing lascivious type, to a hardcore born-again Christian. My friends and I thought that he lost his mind. Now, it has happened to me. Our group has dwindled as each of us gets picked off as the years progress. I can explain what happened to my friends now in scientific, historical, and current political terms. So, reader, if you think my account is an isolated event and you don't feel like you should do anything, it is merely a matter of time. This is how Nazi Germany went as far as they did. Everyone stood by in disbelief as they heard the accounts of the evil deeds, and because of the incredible mass scale and excessive brutality, people were unable to accept the accounts as being completely true. The same strategy is being used again but by the United States on its own people. No one will stand up, believe, or even think about that the taboo topic of mental illness might be a cover-up, just like how the government used what they called retarded children in their radiation experiments for 30-plus years. I believe that the term radiation has been purposefully confused in much of the literature. The word radiation is used to describe two different kinds of energy release. Classical use of the word radiation means that an alpha particle was released like from uranium. But an acceptable use of the word means electromagnetic radiation, which is just photonic energy, that is directed energy radar. These are possibly more word games and brand confusion techniques of the traitors conducting informational warfare. Propaganda, word games. One, the United States military leader in an article called, "The Mind Has No Firewall," coined a term called psychoterrorism. It means terrorizing citizens with psychotronic weapons. Guess what they are doing to thousands of Americans and others in NATO countries? It is nothing less than federally sponsored terrorism. They prefer to call it weapons testing, though. Precise language is important in communicating ideas, and more importantly, it reveals how the communicator changes language for their intention. The word terrorism is a perfect example. Break down what this marketing term means. It means guerrilla warfare and to terrify the populace. How do you distinguish it from normal guerrilla warfare? Is trying to destroy the Pentagon and hurt the financial center at ground zero really terrorism, or just very strategic targets to take out your enemy? Who benefits from the population being frightened? Paranoia favors government in rallying the people's support for a fight. It does not favor the other side. They could have killed more people by going to a football stadium with machine guns at the exits. They are trying to stop a system, not kill the citizens, just as we are in Iraq. The word was coined as propaganda by those that are most threatened in order to garnish support for their cause. Another phrase that has more meaning now than it did when it was coined is living the American dream. We are allowed to create a myopic worldview for ourselves. We can be sheltered from knowing or caring about the hardships of the rest of the world. We don't even have to care about our neighbors anymore. Selfishness and the me generation currently rule. The mass news media and Hollywood will help create the American delusion for you. You can live in happy bliss ignorant of politics, corruption, and other pesky concerns. Replace the bigger questions and concerns with the immediate ones, like where is the nearest Starbucks and when do I get a raise? How I reminisce about the simple life, and on occasion I wish I could be reinserted into the Matrix, the American delusion. But I carry the burden of knowledge, and with that responsibility to educate and motivate the 300 million people into action, a force that is unstoppable if they would just be told the God's honest truth about the secrets which the Pentagon holds from them in both technology and strategy. The populace would have a very different opinion than what is fashionable now if they knew and believed the truth of the larger picture. What I would like to clarify is the vocabulary surrounding this relatively new breed of weapon called EEG heterodyning. It has so many misnomers and misdirections surrounding it in literature. In an effort to confuse the public, the EEG heterodyning weapon goes under many names: non-lethal weapons, soft kill weapons, silent kill weapons, directed energy, bioelectromagnetic weapon, psychic warfare, psi weapons, psychotronics, neurological weapons, neuralizer, nervous system disruptors, electronic weapons, EEG cloning, mind melding, ionospheric heaters, over-the-horizon radar, continental ballistic missile defense, and the list goes on. A constantly changing vocabulary around this weapons system has confused the topic to the point of non-discussion. Genius or insanity? Throughout history, geniuses have often been misclassified as insane. Galileo was wrong for 300 years according to the church. Since I have been told by non-government experiment victims that I am like Nash from The Beautiful Mind, I must address this topic directly. We need to more precisely define insanity to understand what it means. Most often it is simply a word to describe an inability to understand an individual's behavior and their speech due to context. Contextualism is of utmost importance when understanding concepts or people. The description of insanity is a cop-out. Most precisely defined, the word insane or mental illness should mean erroneous thinking. Erroneous thinking can only be judged in the framework of logic and mathematics. It should not be judged as psychology would have it, in the context on common acceptable ideas. Delusion and errors of thought must be demonstrated through the framework of truth that has endured the test of time. While many of the government torture test victims show an amplification of neuronal pathways in the front temporal lobes, we should not discount their testimony based on this. Errors of thought are amplified with Satan, silent assassination through amplification of neurons. In order to separate out what is true and what are just perceptional errors, you need to study a victim's testimony from the viewpoint that you already know about how these weapons work. It becomes quite apparent how each person interprets the alien experience of having their mind messed with differently. What if we had a national truth day? I'll break my staff. Bury it certain fathoms in the earth. And, deeper than did ever plummet sound. I'll drown my book. The Tempest, 5. 1. Imagine how strange it would be if we had one day where everyone had to tell the truth. The news might go like this. This is the 6 o'clock news on Truth Day. Today government officials fed radiation to hundreds of people while posing as cafeteria workers to test the long-term carcinogenic effects from radiation. 3 more people have been grabbed for the Gultra torture and mind control experiments and practice assassinations. One of the victims was a whistleblower and was successfully killed right away in a car crash. The government denies that there is any connection between whistleblowing and the selection of this target. They say that they do everything fairly and they randomly select people to torture and kill for their data and practice. Also, 500 Navy officers were exposed to extremely high levels of electromagnetic energy unbeknownst to them during another experiment. We are not allowed to release who was exposed because they will be upset if they found out. One soldier was wounded in Iraq today because his buddy accidentally shot him while playing with his gun. The final numbers have been retallied for Desert Storm and yes, we killed more of our own allies than the Iraqis, but it was close. Yet another strange story of government experimentation is giving methamphetamines, or energy drinks, to fighter pilots before their missions. Aren't drugs banned in the military? I wonder how the don't ask don't tell policy is holding up on Truth Day. The last story of today is to answer the question, can the government read brain activity at a distance? As it turns out, they have had this capability since 1960 and they claim it is all nice and legal-like when asked to comment. And finally, when Porter Goss was interviewed at a press conference and asked if the CIA uses torture on Iraqis in order for the United States to free Iraqis from a torturing dictator, he stated, "No, we creatively interpret laws and redefine words. We also strip away the CIA agent's title during the torture process to make sure it is all legal." This news station and the reporters have all been indirectly threatened that if we have any more truth days, we will suffer in our own private psychotronic purgatories. So this will be the last broadcast that we tell it like it is. Thank you and have a good evening, America. Strategic deception and purging the erroneous. Error propagation can not only be achieved through memenic warfare, social engineering, but also direct electromagnetic entrainment and programming of brains. These purposeful errors of understanding and thought are extremely detrimental to the global distributed intelligence of the geopsyche. Only through truth unbridled by ego shall mankind achieve harmony with itself and our place in the universe. Purposeful error propagation leads to suboptimal decision-making in chaotically unpredictable ways that harms everyone on the planet. This is the mission of the CIA, Psychological Operations, Information Warfare Unit, INSCOM, and many others division that practice strategic deception. They need to be eradicated for the good of the country and planet, for they too are programmed and influenced by the very errors they create in the self-fulfilling spiral of self-destruction. These agencies are a tool that have turned on the tool users and makers. Part of the disinformation campaign for mind control victims. When one becomes part of the TAMI network, one naturally goes to the internet for information. I found many documents in the military information warfare strategy that talk about how to lead the enemy down fruitless paths of research with slightly erroneous logic that leads to an endless maze of false assumptions and deductions. This is part of the strategic deception initiatives launched on the American people. This disinformation warfare has confused and stupefied many people, helping them sound crazy about the science behind their predicament. Colonel Thomas Bearding is the perfect example of this initiative. He invented the concept of scalar waves and weapons that he warns the Russians possess and the United States scientists know nothing about. He talks about weather and earthquake weapons and zero-point energy. He has a good education in physics, so I can't come to any other conclusion than he is a disinformation agent or a victim of menticide. All his theories are so purposefully skewed. Since he talks about mind control and then discusses all these ridiculous scientific ideas about free energy, faster-than-light information propagation, and electromagnetic vortexes, the mere idea of mind control weapons is also put into question. This is the classic method of discrediting a topic. Disinformation streams.